Welcome to Module 3, Part 2. Information disclosure. Information disclosure is the confidentiality breach of the CIA triad. It could be customer information, credit card information, other sensitive information, or can be proprietary or other confidential information or business operation details. Disclosure of debugging code, sample testing applications in a software application, or improper validation, all that can reveal information disclosure. Information disclosure can take advantage of system design and implementation mistakes, such as failing to remove debugging code, leaving sample application and accounts. When you develop the software, you will create sample applications or accounts and you will not remove it. Very detailed error messages also can result in information disclosure. Which means, suppose if there is a firewall and the firewall is connected with the internet, from the internet, if a user is talking to this particular interface, perimeter interface, if he send an FTP traffic towards that, this interface is, for example, 20.0.0.10, that is not an FTP server, but still the attacker send an FTP packet towards that particular IP address, then the firewall should block it or simply leave it. Instead, if the firewall says that I'm so-and-so firewall running on Windows, this is the version, you're not allowed. Which means this detailed error messages can also reveal certain details to the attacker. So very detailed error message also can result in information disclosure. DoS stands for Denial of Service Attack. DoS attack prevents authorized users from using a resource. If the authorized user is prevented using a resource, that means it is a denial of service attack. It is an attack on the availability of the CIA triad. There are very handy tools like LOIC, Low Orbit Ion Cannon, and HOIC, High Orbit Ion Cannon. Both the tools can be used to create a DoS attack so that the required resources in the system can be exhausted. DoS attacks is from a single source. DDoS is a distributed denial of attack where the attacker attacks the target from multiple sources at the same time. Escalation of privilege. An ordinary user can become an administrator by escalation of privilege attack. An attacker gets greater privilege and access that originally allocated to the user or the victim. So the privileges given to the victim has been attacked by the attacker and he escalates the privilege to become an administrator so that he can gain control of the machine. This can be done through theft of credentials of a higher level account by an internal or external attacker. If an ordinary user can manipulate the privileges given to him or her and can escalate it to that of an administrator, that's an internal person, or to obtain a root access, it is known as escalation of privileges. This can be done through theft of credentials of a higher level account by an internal or external attacker. It also might be accomplished through an application exploit that grants additional powers to an otherwise limited account. There are many ways. So escalation of privilege means escalating the privileges so that you will become an admin or you will gain the root access of the machine so that you can gain control of the machine and applications or use that machine as a weapon to destroy other machines. OWASP, OWASP stands for Open Web Application Security Project. They publish the top 10 vulnerabilities every year. OWASP is a non-profit charitable organization focused on improving the standards of security in software. These are the top 10 vulnerabilities they update every year. You are encouraged to visit www.owasp.org to get further details. Let's now look at some of the attacks. Malware attack. Malware is a malicious software that damages or disables computer systems. Malware is a type of software or a piece of code that's written specifically to infect or harm the system on which it runs. It can damage or disable the computer system. There are codes written specifically to infect or harm the systems, applications, softwares, and other files. It's basically an umbrella term used to refer to a wide range of intrusive or disruptive type of softwares. So the malware, the umbrella term includes specific malicious and dangerous codes with specific functional objectives such as virus, worms, trojans, rootkits, backdoors, botnet. I have given 2-3 bars here. It has no significance. Just to give a design I have created. All these virus, worms, backdoor, spyware, everything comes under the umbrella term malware. These codes can delete the files from your machine, stop running your process, can start the malicious process automatically in your system. It can slow down your computer, it can steal personal information from your system, such as stealing the password. It can send spam mails to the other emails. It can commit a fraud and cause complex identity theft. Social engineering. Here, let us discuss impersonation, tailgating, and shoulder surfing. All these comes under social engineering. Impersonating a trusted source in order to gain access. That means entering the premises, pretending as a technician is impersonation. Tailgating is when an unauthorized person enters the building or gate close behind an authorized person. Suppose there is an authorized person, he goes to a door, show his ID card, he opens the door, and after he passes through the gate, the attacker go close behind to that authorized person is known as tailgate. Shoulder surfing is using direct observation techniques such as looking over someone's shoulder, especially when we standing in the ATM queues or crowded places. This is what social engineering is, trapping the people. DAD is the opposite of CIA. When the confidentiality is broken, it will result in disclosure. When the availability is broken, it will result in destruction. When the integrity is broken, it results in alteration. So the compromise of a CIA results in DAD. Destruction, alteration, and disclosure. So disclosure, alteration, and destruction are results when the confidentiality, integrity, and availability is compromised. Please follow the continuation part. Thank you.